My name is Ida, and today I will teach you how to play When It Rains It Pours by Tokio Hotel. And to play the song you need three chords, so I will teach you those chords first. We have E minor. That sounds like this. For this chord, you put your first finger to the second fret and the first string, and then your second finger to the third fret and the second string, and your third finger to the fourth fret, third string. Ooh. And that's E minor. And then we need G. To play G, you place your first finger to the second fret, third string, and your second finger to the same fret, second fret, third string, and then your third finger to the third fret, second string. And that's G. And then for the third chord, which is D, we take all of those three fingers and we place them on the second fret on the top three strings. Like this. And that's actually all of the chords that we need. And we're going to play them in that exact order. We are going to play E minor. And that is going to last twice as long as the others. So E minor. And then G and D. And that is the structure of the chords for the whole song. And now we're going to talk about the strumming. In my cover, I try to kind of mimic the rhythm of the original. And the original is in 6/8, I think, when it comes to time measurements. That's what it sounds like to me anyway. And what that basically means is that you count to six and then you start at one again. And I can demonstrate with the chords. As I said, the E minor lasts twice as long as the others. So if I'm just going to play the chord and count, it sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then with even strums on each beat, it sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that's not very interesting to listen to. So what I do to make it sound more interesting is that I kind of intensify some of the strums on some of the beats. So you can do that on the fourth beat or like the beats that lead up to you changing the chords, because that will like create some kind of drive in the song. And that can sound like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1. And you play that way for the whole song, so the verse and the pre-chorus and the chorus have the same kind of chord system. And in my cover, I also did like an intro with two rounds of those chords. So I thought that I could just play the first half of the song to demonstrate for you with like the strumming and the chords and everything, and then I will put some graphics of the chords on the screen so that you can follow along. And as you can notice, I also stop on the D sometimes to kind of create a kind of space between the different parts. So with the intro and the singing, it sounds like this. I don't know where you go, hard for you to share home, 'cause you don't want it all, it's what we have disposable. I want more, something beautiful, someone that I can count on and know. When it rains, it pours, feels like I'm on my own, please don't try to ignore that. I don't wanna do this. then it goes like a round of some the same chords again. And as you could hear, I sung the last part of the refrain a bit differently from the original because I didn't do any kind of harmonies or anything, and I wanted to make some kind of difference between the two different repetitions of that chorus. And I guess that's it. When you are playing the song, you just kind of repeat this, and then you sing the second verse, and then there is this like quiet part at the end of the song. The pre-chorus kind of gets the role of a bridge, where it has a more soft sound, and for that one I just strummed all of the chords once. But you can listen to my cover to see how I played it and how like the parts come after each other. If you're watching this tutorial, you probably know the song already, so I don't think that will be a problem. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, just ask me in the comments and I will answer. There are only three chords, but it's still kind of hard to play because the strumming is a bit difficult to kind of nail, so you can obviously play another kind of strumming if you think this was hard to manage. But yeah, just ask if you have any struggles. And if you are a Tokio Hotel fan, then you can tell me if you want me to do other songs, covers or tutorials. I have done some before, but not really any of the old ones. So just tell me if you would like to see that. So yeah, like this video if you liked it, and subscribe for more. And that's it. I hope you will have a very nice day, and I will see you soon. Bye! I don't know where you go, how for you to share your home, 'cause you don't want it all, it's what we have disposable. I don't know.